Tomorrow, part of Everest Canal will be shut down for parts of the day so city crews can dive down to work on a bubble curtain where the canal meets the Caloosahatchee. The city installed these devices last year to help fight algae blooms.
NBC2's Gina Tomlinson is showing us why these little devices you may have never noticed are a big deal to keep our water clean.
Algae mats and canals, something we've already seen this month in Southwest Cape Coral. They're not hard to miss.
So you can definitely see that algae floating on the water. Hopefully it doesn't get as bad as it did.
Trying to stay ahead of the problem, the city of Cape Coral will be doing some maintenance on a bubble curtain on the east side. Starting tomorrow, divers will be next to the midpoint bridge where the canal connects with the Caloosahatchee.
The bubble curtain is working as the first line of defense, fighting off blue-green algae from the water.
We run the jet skis on them pretty much daily, so we definitely want to keep the water clean.
Chase Myers with Naughty Hooker Water Sports and others using the Horton boat ramp will have to be patient until Friday. The entry to Everest Canal will close for 15 to 20 minutes at a time while the bubble curtain work goes on.
This park right now is extremely popular, especially with some of the ramps closed. In Lee County.
We've been coming here because the yacht club is closed mostly and because the other beaches with the red tide just south of here.
Some like Chris Bellstrom don't want to see any more issues with the water.
Love it. That's why we come.
The city says diffuser plates at the bottom of the canal produce bubbles that keep algae from entering canals. In Cape Coral, I'm Gina Tomlinson, NBC2.